Some of America's hardest working men and women are farmers.
Any price drops would affect more than 300,000 farmers.
Their numbers are off the charts.
That hit our farmers and ranchers very, very hard.
For all the talk we can do about a trade war, it's in a place like this where they're there.
What if you could just make all of the challenges go away? We realize there's a lot at stake, and your decisions don't get easier. You need success this season, and to do that, your farm has to be profitable. It's difficult to know where to invest first every year, but your farm and family's future depend on it. We believe it shouldn't be that hard to figure out where to get started, and that a profitable operation is possible. The most important season to think about right now is this one. That's why we've created the 200-Acre Precision Technology Institute, a resource for growers from around the world to come and learn from over 50 test plots. It's why we've cataloged over 12 million corn plants, created a library of hundreds of soils, and individually weighed 20,000 germinating seeds. Whether you're just beginning to monitor your equipment performance or fine-tuning your equipment to the unique variables of your farm, we're here to help. Talk to one of our dealers. Take a few notes throughout the day. This is your year to know that you're doing the best you possibly can for your farm, your future, and your family.
All right, good morning. Welcome to Precision Planting. Welcome to Winter Conference 2019. You know, we are honored to get to spend the day with so many great growers and dealers from all around the world. A special welcome to all of you joining via simulcast. We're simulcasting today out to a number of venues in North America. I also want to make a special welcome here in Tremont. We've got some groups. We've got a group from Argentina. We've got a group from Brazil. And we've got a group from the Ukraine. And so today is being translated to those growers. So we're especially honored for you to travel here and spend this day with us. You know, as we prepare for this and think about it, I love the intro video that kind of puts everything in perspective. There's challenges out there. They're real. But there's opportunity. And that's what kind of drives us. And that's hopefully what you'll see kind of the theme of today. But as we're preparing for this, I pulled out a book that was written by Derek Souder. If you've been around precision planting for a long time, you knew Derek. For those of you that haven't, he was engineer number one. So he was the first full-time engineer at Precision Planting. And as he became ill a few years ago, he was encouraged to write down some of his thoughts and principles that were part of building this business. And there was a part that stood out to me this year. And it was in the introduction where he just said, you know, we've got three responses to adversity, to the challenges that we face in life. The first is that we can complain and blame. The second is that we can wait for someone else to fix it. Or then third, we could take responsibility for our own success. If you knew Derek, he really embodied that third way. And that DNA, I think, is still a part of who we try and be here at Precision. And I think it's also very true of all of you. This is about looking at challenge, but finding the opportunity and moving ahead and making the most of that. So, Winter Conference. If you haven't been here before, you're not going to stay in this seat here in Tremont for very long. We're going to move into breakout sessions pretty quick. And you're going to hear from a team. There's a big team behind everything going on at Precision Planting that is doing research of agronomists and engineers out in the field. And this Winter Conference is especially fun because it's kind of the culmination of some years of research, some areas that we've been looking at and researching for a number of years, okay? You can see there's a planter over here and some row units that are covered up. You're going to see some new things, some new products that for the first time we're debuting for you to be able to look to take into your operation. But you also see up on the screen is kind of a little bit about our approach. And so before we go into the breakouts, I'm just going to set this up a little bit as to how we think about it. And you see measure and adjust. It starts with good measurement. We've got to get good information. And then we can adjust. You can take control. We can start to manage the variables. There's a lot of variables hurting us, our yield, our profitability out on the farm. So we got to measure those, and then we got to adjust and take control of that. So you think about measurement. I think this quote is great from a U.S. Navy Rear Admiral. One accurate measurement is worth 1,000 expert opinions. Right? You look at the grain truck. There's a lot of opinions about yield. There's one measurement that really matters. Right, we get that ticket, coming across. It says what it really is. So measurement for us means a couple different things. And you heard it in that intro video. It starts with our team getting out in the field. So part of, there's a saying around here that you'll hear even today. Again, if your boots aren't dirty, you're not doing your job. So our team starts by going out and measuring what is driving yield in the field and what's pulling us back and looking for problems that then we could create a solution to. So you heard some of the stats in the intro video. 12 million plants have been categorized, hundreds of soils. Over 20,000 seeds were individually measured. You saw the toothbrush with a team to measure germination. So those measurements are kind of the starting point. So our team's starting, getting out in the field. So that leads our product development, that leads to how we develop a solution. But we also say, how do we get that measurement to you? So part of today is just sharing our research. You're just gonna hear from our agronomists and engineers some of the findings and what we're learning in that process. But we also say, how do we get it to you on your farm? That's what really matters, right? Here's what we're finding, but you gotta take that home. And the heart of that for us is the 2020 monitor. That's really the heart of getting you good information and good measurement. And so for years, this has been measuring equipment, measuring the planter pass, making sure we are dialing everything in to get the top performance. This last year was an exciting advancement in the 2020. There's a new monitor, the Gen 3 platform. It was announced at this conference last year. But another part that went along with that was the smart firmer. So for the first time, you can see the soil. You can actually measure the environment, not just the equipment, but now the soil environment that you're in. Real time, you're getting moisture, temperature, residue, organic matter. Get that reading and be able to now make adjustments on that. So we learned a lot. There's a lot of growers here that ran those for the first time and learned a lot. So one of the breakouts will be Dale Cook, the product manager of Smart Firmer, and Doug Wiegand, talking about some of the questions, some of the things that we learned as we went through this and as you first ran this in your soils. So you're gonna hear a big theme throughout the day, soil density, soil management. Now that we have this new level of measurement, what can we do with it? And how do you actually manage that to be able to dial in and control some of those additional variables? So once we have the measurement, then we can adjust, right? So adjustment is another part of our product development process, and that's where once we get accurate measurement, like a load pin measuring downforce, now we can add a delta force cylinder. Or once we know organic matter and variability in our field, we can add an MSET V drive to be able to vary the rate or vary the hybrid as you go across the field. Or V apply to be able to vary our nutrient application as you go across the field. So we look at giving you information to be able to make those adjustments and then develop products in that. So over the years, there's been a lot of exciting technology to really take control and adjust the planning process. And you look at the row unit and you see on the front end, all kinds of electric motor and hydraulic cylinder and sensors. But we've known there's still issues, and we go out in the field and we still see issues with the planting process that we're just not satisfied with. You zoom in on the back of the planter. I mean, these are the couple of areas we've been looking at, as I mentioned, for a number of years. And what do you see? You see a couple of T-handles, right? If we have a T-handle to make adjustments, what do we know about that? It's pretty hard to have good visibility in the cab. It's hard to know where it should be set in the first place because we don't have any feedback telling us. And it's pretty difficult to make adjustments, especially on the fly, as we go through the field. So our team's been looking at this, looking at those areas that are both, we all know, crucial. That's our closing system. That's our depth setting. So we say, I think we can do better. So you see a picture here of this planter. This is a planter we built 6 years ago. And if you look at it, you'll see different manufacturers' row units on it. You look at different closing systems. So starting 6 years ago, our team would take this planter, start down in the Delta, start planting in Louisiana, move with the weather north, come through the Corn Belt, end up in the Red River Valley. This picture is actually taken outside of Fargo. And so you can see our team. There's a small army there digging in the dirt, just evaluating how those different closing systems are performing and understanding the different variables and what's working, what's not. And a big part of it is getting in different environments. Because what we find is something that works great in one environment might not work that well in another environment. We need to be able to understand that. You know, this is a field from this last year, just in Morton, Illinois, not too far from those of us in Tremont. And you can see the flags, but if you look closely, you can also see popsicle sticks. There's different colored popsicle sticks that are measuring this. All the plants in this field, spike counts and emergence, to just understand the slightest variables and how it's performing. The fun thing about this research was this last year wasn't just researching other products. This was also evaluating our new closing system. So today, for the first time, you're going to get to see FurrowForce, which is a new closing system option that you'll have the opportunity to put into your operation here in the future. And so as you look at FurrowForce, you can see it's a multi-stage system. So it's real key. You're going to hear again, soil density management. We're looking to manage that soil density and then be able to, with those, the rear wheel, stitch that, close the trench, and make sure we're putting that seed in the best environment to be successful. What's really exciting about FurrowForce, though, is it's smart. A big part, it starts with measurement, right? So you'll see on there, there's a load pin that plugged into a 2020 is going to get, for the first time, the reading. So you can see in the cab, what is the force on my closing system? How is it performing? And then do I need to make an adjustment? You see an airbag. So you can make a manual adjustment, or once we have that reading with that sensor, we can automate that and be able to adjust it automatically, row by row, as you go across the field. So Jason Stoller and Matt Bennett are going to be right here. That's what's underneath these curtains, and they're going to talk through the research that led us to this point, to this design. There's been a lot of findings that have got us to this place. They're going to share that and just kind of share the process, and you'll get to see it. They'll do a demo, and you'll get to see what this looks like and how that reacts. So you go back to the row unit. That's one of the T-handles, but there's still another one, right, our depth adjustment. And so depth is something we all know is crucial to getting good emergence. There's a lot of research, years of research on that. But what really happened as we looked at it is we go to another level of measurement, right? And with Smart Firmer, now we're able to see at a whole new level when we look at moisture and we look at temperature. And so our team, this is research from this last year. This is 300 acres of just specific depth research that our team was doing with Smart Firmer data, but also just still getting in the dirt, digging, seeing what's going on out there. And so again, what was exciting about this last year's research is it's not just evaluating depth, but it's also evaluating another new product that you'll get to see today called the Smart Depth System. So this is an option to replace that T-handle with an electric motor that now from the cab, you can easily make an adjustment in depth. And it's you'll see a calibration process. It's been amazing. As we've learned, many of you have done this. Our dealers are out there performing, calibrating, setting depth. We find a lot of variability, just even when one row to the next on the same planter is set in the same notch, and we find variability. And so just calibrating that and being able to manage that from the cab, we think there's a lot of opportunity there. But what's really exciting is when we pair it with Smart Firmer. Again, it starts with measurement, and so now for the first time, we've got moisture readings real time, and we'd have the ability to give you the option to adjust automatically based on that reading, based on the moisture of what's in the trench real time as you go across the field. So another one of the breakouts, we'll be going through this, Justin McMenemy and Bryce Baker. We've got a planter set up back in R&D with 16 rows of this, and they'll actually run it and go through the calibration, and you'll get to see that in action and understand more about all the research that we've been finding relating to moisture as that key driver. So another exciting new product that you'll get to understand more about throughout the day. So there's a lot of good things in the breakout. Those of you in Tremont were given a notebook. This has got your schedule as you move around. I'll talk through that here in a few minutes. There's one other breakout I didn't mention where Corey Mulbauer and Jeremy Hodel will talk about nutrient management and some different testing we've been doing on different fertility programs that you'll get to just hear what we're finding and maybe challenge some of the status quo as you look at your fertility programs on the farm to really do both things, drive yield, but also most importantly, profitability, just in managing timing of what we're doing. So it's another great breakout that you'll hear some more of our research from the agronomist. At the end of the day, those of us at Tremont are all gonna come back here into this room, and Jason Webster is gonna kind of tie everything together. Many of you know Jason. He joined us a few years ago, and this last year, as an agronomist, he took on the challenge of, he got the opportunity to get a 200-acre farm outside of Pontiac, Illinois, which is about an hour from here. And so he put in a number of research plots that really in all these different areas. So he'll share some of that data. He also had 40 acres where farmers could come out and actually test drive the equipment. So if you hear about all this technology, say, man, I want to see that run first. I want to get in a cab and see what that's like. That was the purpose of this farm in Pontiac. And this last year, we had a lot of fun with thousands of growers from all around the world coming out. So he'll share some of his experiences, what was learned out there, as well as just tie all this together with some of the research that we've found and that really ties into the different themes you're going to be hearing throughout the day. Okay? So I think there's going to be questions. You know, and as this event has grown, we've done Q&A at the end. We've done text-in questions. Truthfully, the event has just gotten too big for us to really come back and answer those well. So I got a couple encouragements for you as it relates to questions. You know, a big part of this is we want to make sure those presenters and the team members that are working, actually doing this research, are the ones presenting to you, right? They're the ones that you're hearing from. And so interact with them during the sessions. You'll have a little bit of time after each session to ask some questions. If not, look them up during lunch. Here in Tremont, there are two display rooms at the simulcast locations. There are also display stands that have these different products on there. There's other white shirts and team members out there that can help answer questions. All the presenters would be the first to say they're just one of a big team that's been working on these projects. So there's a number of other folks that can help answer questions. The second encouragement is to say, make sure you're connected to a premier dealer. You know, many of you came with your dealer. These are the guys that really help take this across the finish line for your farm, your county, your operation. So we've got a number of great dealers around the world. They're the ones that over time, as we continue to bring these products out, they can reach back, get in touch with the right folks here at Precision to make sure you get the answers that you need, okay? Those of you on social media, hashtag PP Winter Conference 2019. Another way to engage with us, join the conversation there. You see it kind of streaming at the different venues, some of the different pictures and thoughts, questions there, and reach out to us that way as well. Okay? You all have notebooks. One reason is the schedule. The second reason, hopefully, you take something away. Maybe it's just an idea. Maybe it is a product. Maybe it's not. Maybe it's an idea you learned from someone that across the lunch table from you. I think this quote is great. If you want something you've never had, you have to do something you've never done. Our job is to bring this latest research to you, to challenge you, give you ideas, encourage you, take some notes along the way. Think about those areas. Find one or two areas that might be something new for you to try to think about in your operation. Okay? With that, we're going to pause a second and cut for the simulcast to have a local host welcome you and talk through the logistics at your venue, and then I will talk through where our next step is here.